Welcome to Master Chem Academy. So today our present topic, preparation methods of carbonyl compounds. This is the part 2. Okay, this is part 2 of this preparation methods. So in the first part I have explained 1 to 7 questions. Now here, so remaining questions after the part 1. Okay, now first question, aldehydes are obtained by alkaline hydrolysis of. So these are the given options, terminal gemdihalides and non-terminal gemdihalides, vicinal and any dihalides. So what is your answer? So your answer must be terminal gemdihalides. So why? So if you take CH3CHCLCL, this is called terminal gemdihalide. Means here at terminal two halogen atoms are there, that's why these are called terminal gemdihalides. Okay, what is meant by gemdihalide? So whenever two halogens present on same carbon, then it is said to be terminal gemdihalide. Okay, now so this terminal gemdihalide, so here alkaline hydrolysis means alkaline, two moles of KOH, okay, to substitute two chlorines with two OH groups, that is CH3CHOH. Okay, so this is diol. Okay, this diol is unstable. This is unstable. Why it is unstable? Whenever two OH groups present on same carbon, that is unstable. That's why, so here loss of H2O takes place. Okay, H plus from here OH minus. Okay, loss of minus H2O takes place and it leads to the formation of CH3CHO. Okay, so whenever these two halogens at a terminal position, and terminal position, then only aldehyde preparation is possible. So aldehydes are obtained by alkaline hydrolysis of terminal gemdihalides. What happens if we take non-terminal gemdihalide? Okay, so non-terminal gemdihalide, so if you take this CH3CHCLCL, this is non-terminal gemdihalide. Why it is? So what is the chain? 1, 2, 3 carbon chain. Okay, now two halogens are present at middle carbon, not at a terminal position. That's why this is called non-terminal gemdihalide. Why it is gemdihalide? So two halogens are present on same carbon. Okay, that's why it is gemdihalide. Now this are 2KOH. Okay, alkaline hydrolysis, what it gives? CH3COH. Here also two OH groups on same carbon, so this is also a called diol, which is unstable. So that's why loss of H2O takes place in the same manner like this. So here loss of H2O takes place and what it gives? CH3C double bond O CH3. So this is called acetaldehyde and this one is acetone. Okay, so what is our conclusion? Terminal gemdihalides leads to the formation of aldehyde, non-terminal gemdihalides leads to the formation of ketones. Okay, so what is meant by vicinal dihalide? Vicinal dihalide means whenever two halogens present on adjacent carbon atoms. Okay, so adjacent carbon atoms, then it is said to be vicinal dihalide. Okay, so here only gemdihalides will give carbonyl compounds, whether either aldehyde or ketone. Terminal gemdihalides gives aldehyde and non-terminal gemdihalides gives ketones. But this is not much useful method. Okay, so this, because here carbonyl compounds are effective, okay, get affected by alkali. So in presence of alkali, carbonyl compounds converts into some other compounds. And also actually dihalogen compounds, gem dihalide compounds are formed, generally usually prepared from the carbonyl compounds itself. That's why, so this is not convenient method, not useful method for the preparation of aldehydes or ketones. Okay, next move on to next question. Okay, next question, ninth one, alkyl magnesium halides, Grignard reagent with HCN followed by hydrolysis, what is the product? aldehyde or ketone, alkane or carboxylic acid. So what is your answer? So first for this should write this reaction HCN and RMGX. Okay, so now due to the more electronegativity, nitrogen gets negative charge and carbon gets positive charge. So here carbon part, this gets negative charge, and metallic part, it gets positive charge. Okay, now here what happens, HC at positive part, negative part is attached to positive part, positive carbon, and positive part attached to the negative nitrogen. So that's why here R double bond N MgX. Okay, so now this undergoes hydrolysis. Okay, this undergoes hydrolysis, that is H2, and here also undergoes hydrolysis. Okay, 2 moles of H2O is required. So for 1 mole is for here, okay, to break this double bond H2O, and here 1 mole HOH. Now this what it gives, RCHO, this is RCH double bond O, RCHO plus NH3 plus OH MgOHX. So these are the compounds formed by this reaction. So what is this? This is aldehyde. Okay, so with HCN, RMGX with HCN, what is the product? It must be aldehyde. Okay, so this is the preparation method for the preparation of aldehydes from Grignard reagents with HCN. Grignard reagent with HCN that leads to the formation of aldehydes. Now how to prepare ketone by this method? How to prepare the ketone? So in place of HCN, we should take alkyl cyanide. I am taking methyl cyanide. Okay, now replace hydrogen with methyl group. Replace hydrogen with methyl group. So in place of aldehyde, so now hydrogen as it is substituted with a methyl group, so that is CH3COR. What is that? That is ketone. So we can prepare ketone, CH3C double bond OR. This is ketone. Okay, so what is your conclusion? HCN with RMGX. So or you can write this RMGX, HCN and hydrolysis. What is the product? It is aldehyde. This is your conclusion. Aldehyde, RMGX. So first CH3CN or any alkyl cyanide by hydrolysis, next that gives ketone. So this is our conclusion from this reaction. Okay, so next move on to 10th question. Okay, next 10th question. So that is CH3COCl plus H2 in presence of palladium and BaSO4, CH3CHO, is it aldehyde plus HCl? This reaction is known as, this is a named reaction, very important. So this is what it is. This is acetyl chloride. Acetyl chloride on hydrogenation in presence of palladium BaSO4. This is called, very important, that is answer is Rosenmund reduction. Okay, what is Rosenmund reduction? Acetyl chloride with hydrogen in presence of palladium and BaSO4, what it gives? CH3CHO plus HCl. This Rosenmund reduction is exclusive for the preparation of aldehydes only. Okay, it is exclusive for aldehydes. So we can prepare aldehydes only. So ketones cannot be prepared. Ketones cannot be prepared by this method. Okay, so this is the named reaction, very important. So we know that what is Stefan reduction. So already we have discussed that CH3CN, alkyl cyanide with SnCl2HCl. And it gives imine, corresponding imine, followed by hydrolysis, that gives aldehyde. This is a Stefan reduction. So this is also a exclusive method for the preparation of aldehyde. Okay, we can prepare only aldehydes with this method, two methods, Stefan reduction and Rosenmund reduction. So here this is important. What is important? your pellet, what is the Rosenmeld reagent? Rosenmeld reagent, hydrogenation in presence of palladium and BaSO4. This is Rosenmeld reagent. Okay, next 11th question. Okay, next 11th question. Pinnacle with in presence of 30% H2SO4 by heating, what it gives? This is very important. Pinnacle-pinnacolone rearrangement. Okay, what is that? Pinnacle-pinnacolone rearrangement. So this answer is, this is pinnacolone. Okay, that is diol. Pinnacle is a diol, and here it is ketone. Okay, so what is this? CH3, CH3, OH, CH3. So in presence of this, so what it gives? CH3, CO, CH3, CH3. This is called pinnacle. This is called pinnacolone. Okay. So what is the exact name of this? So 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbon chain. So 2,3-dimethyl, 2,3-dimethyl, 2,3-butanediol. Okay. 2,3-dimethyl, 2,3-butanediol. Okay. So this is called pinnacle. Okay. Now, what is this? So here 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Here this is 3,3-dimethyl, 2-butanone. So this is called pinnacolone. Pinnacolone. 3,3-dimethyl, 2-butanone. So this also called as methyl, common name methyl. So this is methyl group, and this one is tertiary butyl. Methyl tertiary butyl ketone. So common name methyl tertiary butyl ketone, or 3,3-dimethyl, 2-butanone. So that is called pinnacolone. So this is called rearrangement. Rearrangement takes place in the complex, in the compound. That's why this is called pinnacle-pinnacolone rearrangement. Next question, 12th one. Acetoacetic ester in presence of aqueous or alcoholic KOH, what is the product? So what is acetoacetic ester? That is CH3, CH3CO, CH2COO, C2H5. This is called acetoacetic ester. Okay, CH3CO, CH2COO, C2H5. These are with aqueous or alcoholic KOH. What happens here? So HOH hydrolysis takes place in this manner, and it leads to the formation of CH3CO CH3 plus CO2 plus C2H5OH. Okay, this is from acetoacetic ester. In presence of aqueous or alcoholic KOH, hydrolysis takes place in this manner and leads to the formation of ketone, acetone. Okay, so that's why it is a exclusive method for the preparation of ketone. Okay, only we can prepare ketones by this method. Aldehydes cannot be prepared. Aldehydes cannot be prepared by this method from acetoacetic ester. Okay, so this is about 12th question, and next move on to next question. Okay, next 13th one. Benzene with here carbon monoxide and HCl in presence of anhydrous AlCl3 Lewis acid. So what is the product? So here reactant is benzene, and here it is benzaldehyde. Okay, benzene to benzaldehyde conversion. So aromatic aldehydes, preparation of aromatic aldehydes. So in this, this reaction is known as very important name reaction, that is Gaterman-Koch synthesis. Okay, Gaterman-Koch synthesis. So what is the difference between Gaterman-Koch and Gaterman synthesis? So here benzene with HCN plus HCl. HCN plus HCl. So what it gives? Benzaldehyde, CHO. Okay. So here, in presence of anhydrous AlCl3, anhydrous AlCl3, or we can use here zinc chloride, ZnCl2. So followed by hydrolysis. Okay. So this is first and second, followed by hydrolysis. So what it gives? CHO. From H2O, it gets this oxygen. So C6H5 CHO plus here NH3 plus HCl. Okay. So this is about Gaterman synthesis. Okay. Gaterman synthesis is, what is the difference between these two? Here carbon monoxide and HCl. Here HCN and HCl. Okay. So like this, you can remember coach. So it is spells like this, co. Okay, co. This is carbon monoxide, coach, carbon monoxide. Like this, you can remember. And remaining this, in place of carbon monoxide, if HCN is taken, that synthesis is known as Gaterman synthesis. Okay. So both the reactions are same. Product is same. Benzene conversion to benzaldehyde. Okay. Here, anhydrous AlCl3. So Lewis acid, along with Lewis acid, second step is hydrolysis. By hydrolysis, it gives benzaldehyde and ammonia and HCl. Okay. So this is about the 13th question. And what is the remaining? Here two options. What is Stefan reaction and Rosenman reaction? Already we have discussed this Stefan reaction, that is CH3C triple bond N. So methyl cyanide, so with SnCl2 and HCl. SnCl2 and HCl, what it gives? CH3, CH double bond, NH, HCl, corresponding hydrochloride. This is imine hydrochloride. So now this on hydrolysis, so hydrolysis takes place in this way. So H and H, so what is this? NH4Cl, CH3CHO plus NH4Cl. So this reaction is known as Stefan reaction. Okay. Now what is Rosenman reaction? So Rosenman reaction is the conversion of acyl chloride, acid chloride plus H2 in presence of palladium and BaSO4. Palladium and BaSO4, what it gives? RCOH plus HCl. Okay. This is exclusive method for the preparation of aldehyde. This is also exclusive method for the preparation of aldehyde. And Gaterman coach and Gaterman synthesis, both are the preparation of aromatic aldehydes. Okay. Next, move on to 14th question. Okay. Next, to 14th one. So here, what is given here? This is toluene. Okay. Toluene. So CrO2Cl2, this is called chromyl chloride. What is this? Chromyl chloride. Okay, toluene with chromyl chloride, so gives A, which on hydrolysis gives B. What are A and B? So here A is this on hydrolysis gives benzaldehyde. So this is also preparation method for the preparation of aromatic aldehyde. This reaction is known as very important name reaction, Itard reaction. Okay. So this reaction is known as Itard reaction. Here important is chromyl chloride in presence of carbon disulfide. Toluene with chromyl chloride in presence of CS2, what it gives? What is A? A is chromium complex. Okay. Chromium complex is formed. This chromium complex later on hydrolysis takes place and results the benzaldehyde. Okay. Remember, this name reaction is Itard reaction. Okay. So this is about 14th question. So Itard reaction, all named reaction is important. Here Itard reaction, and what we have discussed so far, Stefan reduction, Rosenman reaction, okay, Rosenman reaction, and Gaterman-Koch reaction, and Gaterman synthesis, and Gaterman synthesis, and now it hot reaction. Okay, so these all name reactions are very important. Okay, next 15th one. So 15th one, so this is benzoyl chloride. Okay, this is benzoyl chloride. So this is for the preparation method for the preparation of aromatic aldehyde. So the product is benzaldehyde, COH plus HCl. Okay, so this is benzaldehyde. Okay, so for aliphatic aldehydes, for the preparation of aliphatic aldehydes, already we have discussed this reaction H2 palladium BaSO4 blindly. So if it is hydrogenation in presence of palladium and BaSO4, that reaction is Rosenman reaction. Okay, that is called Rosenman reduction. Okay, what is the Rosenman's reagent? H2 in presence of palladium and BaSO4. So this is the for the exclusive method for the preparation of aromatic aldehydes. Okay, next move on to next question. Okay, next 16th one. So here also this is toluene with Cl2 in presence of HNu, like alkanes in presence of Cl2 and HNu. So this is A is C6H5CHCl2. Okay, one of the product of chlorination in presence of photolytic HNu. So that is benzoyl chloride. What is this? A benzoyl chloride. So this on hydrolysis gives B, that is benzaldehyde. Okay, this is also one of the important preparation method for the benzaldehyde. Okay, so to get benzaldehyde from this one of the product of halogenation in presence of HNu. Okay, that is benzoyl chloride, CHCl2. So, four types of products are formed. So, that is CH2Cl, CHCl2, CCl3. Okay, so from this one of the product is benzoyl chloride. On hydrolysis, it gives benzaldehyde. So, this is side chain reaction. Okay, because reaction happened at side chain due to the HNu. Okay, without HNu, so if Cl2 in presence of any Lewis acids, so nuclear halogenation takes place. Okay, ortho and para chloro toluene are the products without HNu. So with HNu, side chain reaction takes place. A reaction undergoes at side chain and leads to the formation of benzaldehyde. Okay, next this is 17th one. So this is phenol. So we know that this is chloroform, phenol with chloroform and NaOH. This is also familiar name reaction, that is Riemer-Tiemann reaction. Read that name reaction is Riemer-Tiemann reaction. What is the Riemer-Tiemann reaction? Phenol reaction with chloroform and NaOH. NaOH leads to the formation of A and B, two types of products. So those two products are ortho hydroxy benzaldehyde and OHCHO. Ortho hydroxy benzaldehyde and para hydroxy benzaldehyde. This is called ortho hydroxy benzaldehyde. This is also called as salicylaldehyde. Okay, this is major and this one is minor. This is para hydroxy benzaldehyde. So this is ortho hydroxy benzaldehyde, para hydroxy benzaldehyde, two products A and B, two products are formed. So but major is this salicylaldehyde. Ortho hydroxy benzaldehyde is known as salicylaldehyde. Why it is major? This is because of the hydrogen bonding. There is a possibility because it is both are in ortho position, so adjacent positions, OH and CHO in adjacent positions. That's why there is a possibility for the formation of hydrogen bonding between hydrogen and oxygen of CHO. So that's why it gets stabilized. It gets stabilization. So due to this stabilization factor, this is major product. So here the hydrogen bonding formation is not possible. So because the both groups are in so far distance. So this is about Riemann-Thiemann reaction. So next move on to 18th one. Okay, next 18th one. Write the products formed by these reactions. So what are the given reactions? Benzene with acetyl chloride in presence of Lewis acid and hydroxyl-CL3. Benzene with benzyl chloride. Okay, benzoyl chloride. And here two moles of benzene with carbon tetrachloride. Okay, so benzene with first one acetyl chloride. So we know that this is famous reaction. These are all are Friedel-Crafts reactions. Okay, Friedel-Crafts reaction. So we know that Friedel-Crafts alkylation, if it is alkyl halide RCl CH3Cl, this is called Friedel-Crafts alkylation. But here it is acyl chloride, that's why it is called Friedel-Crafts acylation. Friedel-Crafts acylation. Due to this Friedel-Crafts acylation, so the product is, which is electrophilic substitution reaction, so gives COCH3. So this is acetophenone. Okay, next with this second reaction COC6H5, this is benzophenone. So plus HCl, so here also HCl byproduct. Okay, this is COC6H5. This is called benzophenone. This is acetophenone by Friedel-Crafts acylation. Acetyl chloride, here it is benzoyl chloride. And what is about the third reaction? 2 moles of benzene with CCl4. So what it gives? First CCl2. So first here C6H5. Okay, two chlorine atoms substituted with two phenyl rings. So that's why this is the product found for this. This on hydrolysis undergoes hydrolysis. So this C6H5COH, two OH groups. So now as two OH groups on same carbon, it is unstable. So it leads to the formation of removal of H2O takes place, minus H2O, and it gives what? It gives C6H5CO C6H5. This is also benzophenone. Okay, so these are the different reactions, example for Friedel-Crafts acylation. Okay, next last question in from this preparation of carbonyl compounds. So which of the following give only aldehyde? Okay, so carbonyl compounds, we know that carbonyl compounds, aldehydes and ketones. So which of the following options gives only aldehyde, not a ketone? So that is, so answer is D, all. So Stefan reaction reduction, Rosenman reduction, and from terminal gem dihalides, from all these methods we can get only aldehyde, not a ketone. So what is Stefan reaction reduction? So that is CH3CN SNCl2 HCl, and here it gives CH3CH double bond NH HCl. So this is imine hydrochloride. So now this on hydrolysis, so OH2. Okay, what it gives? CH3CHO plus NH4Cl. So only aldehyde. And next, second one, Rosenman reduction. What is that Rosenman reduction? Acetyl chloride, CH3COCl plus H2 in presence of palladium and BaSO4. In presence of palladium and BaSO4, what it gives? CH3COH plus HCl. Okay, this is also acetaldehyde, only aldehyde. And next, terminal gem dihalide. So this is CH3CHClCl. This is terminal gem dihalide. Now here 2 moles of KOH, okay, alkaline hydrolysis. So CH3CHOH. whenever two OH groups on same carbon, it is unstable. So that's why removal of H2O takes place. Removal of H2O takes place, and minus H2O that gives CH3CH2O. Okay, so this is about from terminal gemmed halides. Also, we can get only aldehyde. With the non-terminal gemmed halides, we can get ketone. But with the terminal gemmed halides, the only product is aldehyde. So that's why by all these reactions, we can get only aldehyde. That's why answer D is correct answer. So this is about preparation methods of carbonyl compounds.